A good diet is essential to good health.
Yes, sir. Life really begins with good eating. And I mean good eating.
Sandra Dubs is the author of My Whole Food Community Cookbook. She is an educator in terms of natural remedies and foods, and she has been your guest in this spot, our food and mood segment, on many occasions. So much so that when she came across this information, I thought you'd like to know about it, because on the Sunday show, Sandra, good morning to you.
Good morning, Libby.
We've talked about migraines and about the fact that it's so debilitating and so disempowering. Whilst there are new medications and things you can do, it is always nice to know if there's something you can do for yourself. That's the hardest thing about feeling awful.
That's right.
You just feel so disempowered. It's nice to be able to do something for yourself.
Well, nowadays we've got a lot more information about food to lift your mood, and especially food as medicine. And over the many years, 30 plus years that I've been involved in nutrition and cooking, my focus has always been on food as medicine. And ginger is one of those foods which is surprisingly helpful for many, many things, from nausea to irritable bowels. But the one thing that's been studied now is ginger for migraines, which is amazing. And they've done some comparative studies on using something like an eighth of a teaspoon of ginger powder versus taking a medication, it's called sumatriptan, to see the results. And most patients feel much better on the ginger than taking the medications, which have, of course, other side effects.
How does ginger help with a migraine?
Definitely it helps to create a blood circulation, and that's a lot of it. In some ancient cultures, in India, for instance, Ayurvedic medicine, which is all about combining mind, body and spirit, they've always used a ginger powder with water as a like a mask when people have headaches. So it's a circulatory, it has an effect on circulation. And there are other, I also remember studying in traditional Chinese medicine by using ginger oil on your inner wrists, which was the stomach meridian. That would also help to stimulate the circulation, help the blood flow.
How does it work with nausea? Because I know it does, actually.
It does. Well, I guess it's like causes some heat energy. I'm not sure of the exact scientific process of how it helps, but it just helps with breaking down some of the or helps with the digestive enzymes in the system. So people have taken it for motion sickness as well, haven't they? But I think that's what those old anecdotal ideas have now been taken to medicine, and they're studying it to see if they can come out with compounds that can be as equivalent or better than pharmaceuticals.
Well, that's interesting information about ginger, and for further reading?
It's always useful to go to the PubMed, which is the US National Library of Medicine, National Institute of Health. And there is, just look up ginger. It's quite easy to do. But there is it's a comparison between the efficacy of ginger and sumatriptan in the ablative treatment of the common migraine. And the authors are Magbuli, Golipur, and a few other guys as well.
Right. Okay.
But it's a double blind trial, which is the gold standard. Means that the researchers nor the patients know which what they're getting.
From the research, when are you meant to take the ginger?
Well, apparently at the first sign of a migraine, mix 1/8 of a teaspoon of powdered ginger or 1 tablespoon of fresh grated ginger in warm water and drink it and see if your migraine lessens. Also, the first sign, 1/8 of a teaspoon in water. Make sure that you buy organic ground ginger, because a lot of ginger that you buy powdered forms are radiated.
We're not eschewing that you throw away your medications. I'm not, at least. But this is something you can do for yourself, right, on
Absolutely.
Top of everything
it's
else.
It's helpful.
It's helpful.
And it's perhaps in conjunction with your normal medication.
Sandra Dubs, whole food educator, author of My Whole Food Community Cookbook. Always a pleasure to have you on a Saturday morning.
Thanks.